previously said in time, when it comes to certain texts,
and now he turned into a gospel preacher.
to be. And if folks always want to remind you of it, and why do they get angry? It's beyond me that you have found something that will stabilize you. You know, folks don't like stability. When you are out there, I mean, y'all know what I mean by out there. Nobody had any direction. There was no leadership. Anything that you wanted to do, you could do it. And most of the time, you wound up getting hurt by it. But then when you make a change and you stabilize and you're happy, folk mad because you're in a better state now than you were then.
Yes, sir.
Paul has found himself in a situation where the government has been brought into the situation. Felix, the governor, of Judea at this time. One of the things that the Romans don't like is disorder. You cause problems out here. That's disorder. Because you know the Roman Empire was going to build on order. That's the reason they had soldiers in the streets, they had a police force in Jerusalem and in all the major cities and territories that they conquered, they put a police force back to make sure that there was order in the province. But now this fellow named Paul, who used to be Saul, has caused disorder in the province. And generally, but Jackson, since it was a religious matter, a lot of times the police didn't deal with that. The Romans didn't deal with that. They would let the leading religious order deal with that. But when that leading religious order caught Paul and was going to do him wrong, then Paul said something that sent a shockwave through all the rest of them. Paul said, "You can't do me like that. I ain't to you for a run-of-the-mill Jew that you can grab off the street and just grab me and take care of me any kind of way you want to. In fact, you better take your hands off me because I am a Roman citizen." On a Roman citizen. Because if you put your hands on a Roman citizen and you deal with them in any kind of way, then you bring down all the fury of Rome when you mess with a Roman citizen. You just didn't do that. And when Paul said, "I'm a Roman citizen," then they said, "Well, listen, Paul said, so I tell you what, I'd rather be put into the hand of the Romans than have to deal with you." But it's bad when your old folk treat you so bad. Y'all haven't seen what I'm dealing with. Ain't it bad when your old folk treat you so bad that you'd rather be put in the hands of your enemy? It's bad to think that your enemy will treat you better than your own. It's bad to think that friends will treat you better than your family. Paul said, let put me in the hands of a Roman citizen. So they came and got Paul, and I'm just trying to cut down on some reading. And he's now in custody with Felix, who was the Roman governor. Now, do I have a minute? Felix is messed up with Rome. They get ready to kick him out. And as we talk about Felix, you understand why they're going to kick him out. Later on, while he's there with Paul, Paul is in custody of Felix. He said, "What did he do?" He said, "Well, he caused all his problems." He said, "Well, what's the problem with him? He wants to go to Rome." And Felix said, "Well, bring him out and let me examine him." So Felix starts talking to Paul. And Paul gives Felix this statement about why he's in custody. And Felix is listening. And instead of Felix passing judgment on Paul, if you read in there, it says Felix was waiting. The reason he was holding Paul so long, he thought that somebody was going to come and bribe him to let Paul go. Now, that gives you kind of an insight there what kind of man Felix is. He was looking for somebody to pay him off. Y'all who know what payoffs are, don't you? If you don't ask Michael Cohen, that's why he can't answer you right now. But he was sitting there trying to hold Paul, thinking that I would get some money out of this. But Paul wouldn't, nobody came to pay the bail, nobody came to bribe the guy. And then Peter said, well, you know, I got my own problem. And so he kept Paul in their custody for 2 years. Wow. 2 years. There's no communication that we have of Paul in custody. And just let me sit there. And then Nero decides to move Felix out of his position and to appoint Festus, who was at Caesarea, to take over that province. Well, when Festus gets into power, he realizes that there's some of Felix's leftover stuff. And one of them is Paul, who's been in there 2 years. And so Festus wants to know, what is his problem? Felix said, well, we got Paul back there. And I could have let him go, and then he started mad. He said, no. But he appealed on the season. No, you didn't let him go because you couldn't get no money out of him. Says, so now he's back here. He said, well, do you want to? Let me in. And so Festus hears Paul and then he puts Paul back. He says, you know what? Agrippa, Herod, who is the figurehead leader of the Jews. And I say figurehead because Festus is over Agrippa. He's just using Agrippa to keep the Jews in place. But anyway, Agrippa and Bernice's wife, they're coming up to greet the new Roman governor. And when they do that, they say, well, you know what? Festus said, we might as well bring Paul out here and let you hear what this man has to say. And so in chapter 26, where I am now, I'm trying to bring you up to what was going on. They say, well, come get Paul out of there and bring him here. And that's when Paul says, I count myself happy that I am permitted to speak for myself. Yeah. And he's talking directly to King Agrippa. Yeah. Now you may ask me, why would he say something to Festus? Festus knows about that. He's talking to Agrippa because Agrippa's supposed to know something about God. In Judaism. I made we proceeded down the Damascus Road.
Yeah.
circumcised anymore. I'm baptizing now. Paul told me I'm not killing folk now. I'm ready to be healed for the cause of Jesus. Paul told me I know I'm going to Rome. And I know Nero don't like Jews. But Nero don't even like his mom. He has her keys. And I know I'm taking my life in my hand when I stand before the emperor of Rome and tell him about Jesus. But sometimes you got to speak truth and power. And when you met Jesus, if you ever met him, he'll give you strength, won't he? He'll give you courage, won't he? I have a relationship with her. He walks with me. Talks with me. And tells me.
My life has never been the same.